You can come to a new instrument waters and sit down and operate it without ever seeing that instrument before because you've operated other waters equipment and you know how it works. Our lead chemist and with my lab director came out 2 weeks ago at Beverly to see the new Zevo. And he sat down, he prepared the samples, put in the instruments, ran it, got his results, never seen in his life.
I think it is very important to use a software which is user-friendly. Working with MassLink is interesting because we can use that software in the Waters Synapse system as well as triple quadrupoles as a Zevo system. So you can add different applications such as target links, metabolinks, quan links. So for your personnel or research assistant or graduate students, it is nice because they work on one system and the same software can be applied to other systems.
I've been working with Waters for 25 years now, almost, with respect to technology development, whether it's HPLC or early in the days before Micromass was acquired by Waters, we worked with Micromass on mass spec technologies. And the idea has always been to create a laboratory where the applications feed off of each other, where there's an integration between the individual pieces of instrumentation to answer the larger chemical questions.
We wanted to work with the Synapt in particular because it is the only commercial instrument to offer inbuilt iMobility spectrometry with coupled to mass spectrometry. So that's been very, very important. And we're having great fun with it and finding out a lot of things about, not only about the protein monomers, but also about the higher order species, the oligomers we see during protein aggregation into either amyloid fibrils or for the virus capsid work we do.
Regarding Waters' new instrumentation, I think I'm very curious about the capabilities of the new triple quad instrument, the new one, the Shivo triple quad, because now we have a specialized source to manage the UPLC flow rates, so we have, I expect, an increase in sensitivity for the people who are working in residue analysis.
The Synapt's really exciting because it's a cutoff instrument, but you can do MS to the E, so you can get a lot of information first pass with just one injection from each sample, which really helps us stretch out the sample that we have. Acuity helps us achieve much higher throughput because the speed of UPLC means that we can really shorten our run times, which helps in terms of method development and sample analysis. But one of the nicer features of the combination of the Acuity and the Synapt is that we can do a lot of different types of work with just the one instrument. And when you're limited in terms of lab space, that's really helpful.
Looking to what is happening and into the future, what we're seeing is better and better mass spectrometry experiments with speed and sensitivity. Although neutral loss scanning is not novel, to be able to do it without loss of sensitivity is very important to us. And as equipment manufacturers, as Waters are improving how they're dealing with this, we're very excited in how we're going to be able to use that, perhaps in the 2012 games.
I think using the Waters products such as the automated purification system, UPLC, MS, and Empower, the software we used, and SFC, for example, the separation instrument, it will help us to shorten our timelines in delivering our product to our customer.
The application of mass spectrometry in general, with its increased sensitivity, is enabling us to look in greater detail at neurological diseases such as Huntington's disease, and hopefully elucidate some markers of disease progression, so that we can catch the disease early on.
One of the great things about working in university research is the enthusiasm and energy of the young people that you work with. These young people are the scientists of the future, and it's a real joy to see them develop as they understand and use the new technology and start to come up with their own ideas about how this can be used to solve the problems that we're interested in. It's a real joy to see them develop into their own independent scientists and the mass spectrometry leaders of the future.